guys, it's your boy Hatfree Speaks. We're gonna go get in today with Queen White Man. Okay, so I want to thank everyone that left comments for this video throughout my catalog of Queen reactions. I can say it's a catalog now, and more recently with, you know, some of the comments that were done some of the videos that were done recently with like Life Is Real, the dedication to John Lennon, and all that good stuff. Okay, so yo, people be saying you gotta check the lyrics out. You know how your boy gets down from the start, man. I don't play no gimmicks on this channel. Always, I've tried to make sure I get the lyrics up first, because fundamentally, I think, and I've said it before, right from the start, man. Right from the start. I've said it. Sometimes the music video, even like watching the official video, whatever, montage, whatever you want to call it, can distract you from the actual essence of the song. Hence why I did lyrics video initially. And some of you guys might be like, no, we should have done the official videos. I might have messed up a few times with that, but I feel like having lyrics and stuff and understanding it is fundamentally an important factor. You know what I'm saying? Definitely important factor, especially with this song, White Man. Okay, so it's the official lyric video. And guys, if you haven't already, I might say this in every damn video I do now. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, notification bell, give the video a like, give it a share, because we're gonna jump in today with Queen White Man. Okay, so I think there was a comment that indicated to me that it was something to do with Native Americans. Spoiler alert. But anyway, with that being said, we're gonna jump in. All right, guys, so let's do it. Brian May. Brian's guitar almost sings it as well.
On our blood and sand. Oh yeah. White man, don't you see the light behind your black sky?
Thing I'd say, wow, man, these lyrics are quite controversial, eh? Flipping hell. Don't you give a light for the blood you shed? Substitute light for the F word, eh? Perhaps. Unless that's supposed to be in there for a reason. Don't you give a light? Don't you give a SHIT for the blood you've shed, perhaps? I don't know. But light here, thrown in this section here, is a bit bizarre. Again, fantastic. Guys, I can give you the spiel. But I'm not here to kiss ass. All right? Yes, I know Queen's fantastic. Yes, I know Freddie Mercury's fantastic. They're all fantastic. Fantastic Four. I've said that. Masterful Musicians. I've said that. Said a lot of stuff. Go check the reactions. You heard it here first. I've already said that shit. Best believe on me. I'm so honest with that. Honestly. Now here, I'm talking about lyrics now. Don't you give a light for the blood you've shed. Now light, if anybody knows, is that actually meant to be a substitute for a curse word? Let it be known. But if it's actually symbolic reason for it being there, light. For the blood, don't you give a light? Are you going to shine the light on the stuff you've done? Is that what it means? Are you going to be accountable for the blood you've shed? Are you going to shine a light on it? Or are you just going to leave it in the dark? Is that what it means, perhaps? Could do. There was a lyric Freddie said that never was shown here. You fight your battle with lies. So they didn't put that in here, but... Right, I was actually, thank you for that, Roger. I'm going to compliment Roger on his drums there as well. Whew. Wow, that was something, eh? That was really something. What was that last line? A man who learned how to teach. What was that? A man who learned how to teach. No, this bit. What is left of your dream? Just the words on your stone. Just the words on your stone. What stone? What's the stone symbolize? You know what I mean? And then the next line. A man who learned how to teach, then forgot how to learn. What? Really? Man, that's really put it out there. A man who learned how to teach, then forgot how to learn. That is, talk about an epic ending to a song with that. A man who learned how to teach, then forgot how to learn. That, my friend, is what you call a bad teacher then. For essence, you know, teaching in itself, you've always supposed to be one of the good teachers or the best or great. You got to be always learning. You have to always continually, you have to always continuously be seeking knowledge or new information in order to make sure you're still learning. And how you adapt to that learning process is how you can sort of bring it forth to, I guess, your students, so to speak, right? But here, that's an example of somebody who is a bad teacher, I guess. A man who, a person, could be a woman, doesn't have to be a man. Okay, well, okay, we're talking about these lyrics, okay? A man who learned how to teach. Okay, I'm going to then forgot how to learn. If you've forgotten how to learn, you can't really teach, can you? But in this context, he's talking about, obviously, the, I guess, immigrants that built the roads over in the jolly old US. I made it obvious, he talked about Redskins. We know that's Native Americans, right? I'm not that naive, man. I am not that oblivious to world issues, all right? So Redskins refers to Native Americans. Obviously, this is talking about that. But I'm just trying to... Okay, so many things. Why is Queen bringing this up? Why are they doing a song like this for a start, right? Why? Secondly, a man who learned how to teach then forgot how to learn. That in itself indicates to me is who's teaching who in that situation. I mean, there's so much going on here. I've never been in the educational system in the US or anything like that. So I'm wondering, you know, early on, do you guys learn about this stuff in school? About the Native Americans, you know, the history and all that? Is it being taught and stuff? Because again, it's Queen doing something, I guess, against the status quo. So if this, I saw the album, Day at the Races. If this was done at that time period, this song might have been a bit too, I'll say it, against the grain. Or now we can say ahead of the curve, whichever way you want to put it, or both. It's a bit of a bizarre song to be released, to be honest. But the message and its lesson in this song is quite unique. I'm actually now inspired or have a conscious approach to how and what happened historically to the Native Americans now because of this song. Bizarre, innit? All right, guys, that was my reaction to it. Queen, White Man, putting it out there, the official lyric video. I've not done the official music video. But it's probably gonna. When I pulled up Queen White Man, I did see some snippets of them performing it live and stuff. But imagine if there's like, correct me if I'm wrong. Imagine if there's a music video to this song, what would it look like? And I just keep thinking about it. Keep thinking about innuendo, that video as well. There were snippets in there that were there were clips in that video. That replicated so like suppression, the regime coming forward. You know what I'm saying? Wow, it's incredible. Jeez, I can't. Again, you know, Brian May, he wrote that song 39 as well, didn't he? Again, that was another vibe in that song that we were talking about time travel, lost love, going through the universe, all that good stuff. And now, you know, White Man, he wrote this song. It's just something. But why? I can't understand. Why would you do this? I'm not laughing at the song, my friends. I'm not laughing at the song. I'm just trying to understand, like, from a musical perspective, if you're a label and you put this song forward, you'll be like, hang on, this is going to ruffle a lot of feathers. It's going to upset the relations between political relations, and perhaps it could have a consequences to this song, guys. Consequences. You can't put a song out like that. Who knows, maybe back then it wasn't taken so seriously and stuff, but in this day and age now, people would say, what, you shouldn't be playing that song anyway. But I respect the song. I've actually learned something from the song, and I'm thankful for Queen, and I guess Brian, Brian May wrote it, for putting it out there, not to be forgotten. Amazing. All right, guys, thank you for everyone that left a comment regarding this song. I do appreciate that. You know, comment sections, again, any sort of songs you do, I'll go through them, guys. I'm still going through them, okay? So if they're still there in the comment section of that, I'll get around to them. If I've forgotten or haven't done it recently, let me know, okay? Because sometimes I'm like that. I've got my blinkers on, and I'm just going full force and going forward. So anyway, thank you so much. Make sure you are staying safe, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.